The Academy Award-winning movie Schindler's List introduced the world to Oskar Schindler and his work rescuing Jews from Nazi death camps.
It's Hebrew from the Talmud. It says, whoever saves one life saves the world entire.
But who was Branislav Huberman?
He was the Schindler of the music world. Schindler saved 1,000 people. Huberman saved 1,000 people, and no one knows him.
Academy Award-nominated director Josh Aronson tells Huberman's story in the documentary Orchestra of Exiles.
He was a hero. He was a heroic character. He was a great, great violinist. He was a great artist, and he was a great man.
A Jewish child prodigy from Poland, Huberman began playing the violin at age 8. He performed throughout Europe and fell in love with the audiences in Palestine.
The film is about a man who starts the cultural life of Israel by founding the Palestine Symphony. And it's about the difficulty and the obstacles, tremendous obstacles, that were in the way of Huberman in doing this. It was before concentration camps. It's before we knew what was coming in Germany. He talked to people about how dangerous it was going to get. And it was eerie that he had this sense. And because of that that sort of inner conviction that it was very dangerous for Jews in Germany and the Jews had to get out.
By the end of 1935, every Jew in the Berlin Philharmonic Orchestra had left the orchestra. Most had been fired. Eventually, the Nazis invited only so-called special Jews to perform. Huberman refused.
From the moment that Hitler came in, Huberman said he would never play in Germany again until every musician who'd been fired from the Berlin Philharmonic was back in their seats, and from the Frankfurt Symphonies and so on and so forth. And he said he wouldn't go otherwise.
Eventually, Huberman decided to form the Palestine Orchestra, a symphony of exiled Jews that would perform music at the very highest levels. He wanted to show the world that the Nazis and their anti-Semitic beliefs could be opposed with the only weapon many Jews possessed. Music. Huberman spent 2 years traveling throughout Europe, auditioning the best musicians. Most were Jews exiled from Central European orchestras. Musicians like highly regarded soloist David Grünschlag. Huberman helped Grünschlag and his family move to Palestine.
Luckily for my family, nobody had to go through the ordeals of concentration camps, thanks to Huberman, because by getting my father out in 1936, to Palestine, not only saved his life, but also his sister's.
One sister was 20 years old, the other was only 16.
That's us, that's Tony and Rosie, a few years apart.
As Hitler's power and influence grew, the Grünschlag girls knew they had to get out. After several embassies rejected their visa requests, they sent a letter to Huberman, who was housed at a Budapest hotel.
And so Tony wrote him, "Dear Maestro, you are our last hope. Please help us."
Huberman agreed to help. 6 weeks later, the two women received student visas and were on their way to Palestine.
He made it all happen, yes.
He knew any Jew he gets out of Europe, he's probably saved his life, or at least spared him a lot of misery and a lot of suffering.
And in the process, Huberman brought music and culture to the desert.
It was a big deal coming to a land where the culture is almost non-existent, but everybody is very, very thirsty for it. There was a lot of excitement in the air, you know, hustle and bustle. This was a country in the making.
Led by Italian conductor Arturo Toscanini, the Palestine Symphony performed its first concert on December 26, 1936. The event was broadcast on radio and heard by millions around the world. Huberman also started a music school. He insisted that all symphony players instruct others, so a new generation of musicians could be built in Palestine. When Israel became a state in 1948, the Palestine Symphony was renamed the Israel Philharmonic Orchestra. Huberman died in 1947, though he never heard his orchestra perform the Israeli national anthem, the Hatikva. His legacy lives on.
So there is this evolution, the seeds of culture that Huberman planted here, that he brought from Central Europe. We are reaping its rewards today, and we will continue to reap its rewards.
I imagine you're a great admirer of Huberman.
I am a great admirer of Huberman.
What do you admire the most about him?
For a man to stand up against intolerance and sacrifice so much of himself and to change himself in doing it, he saw something happening in the world that demanded a response. And so many people today, and this is, I hope, the lesson of the film, so many people are so quick to look the other way.
Aronson's film helps people look at Nazi anti-Semitism and see how one man not only used music to save hundreds of lives, but also to restore a little bit of humanity to an entire world. Gary Lane, CBN News.